Hey everyone, it's me, Nathan from Nathan's Way. Happy Pride, everyone. Yes, still Pride Month. Okay. A lot of stuff has happened in my personal life in June, so I'm going to continue Pride Month until I finished all these book reviews that I wanted to do. And yeah, I'm really excited. Don't forget about my giveaway. The cutoff date is July 13th at the end of the day, whatever time zone you're in. So yeah, enter the giveaway. It is amazing. I love it, and I'm very proud of what I put into this giveaway. There are local queer artists, vendors, business owners, and just queer creatives that put their heart and soul to their work, and I'm very proud of this. So yeah, check the little info bar up there and look at the link down below, and I am so happy for this. On July 15th, there will be a winner announcement, and then there are a couple other dates that I added just in case is the original winner doesn't respond or I can't get a hold of them. So today I am doing a dyslexic book review of The Deviant's War, The Homosexual versus the United States of America by Eric Cervini. Dr. Eric Cervini. He is a doctor with a PhD. And I really thoroughly enjoyed this book. Now, I did listen to the audiobook because right now I'm under a lot of stress in my personal life, and with my dyslexia I cannot focus on reading words right now. I do have a Kindle version of this with the audiobook, so it helps me to read along while I'm listening to it, and doing that really helps me with my pacing my read, so I don't have to use this as a crutch when I'm less stressed, and I can use this. So it's just a different way of reading. I find what works, I do what works, and I love books. So whatever helps my dyslexic self get through a book is more than welcome. So let's talk a little bit about the audio. Now, the audio is really well done. Vikas Adam is the one who did the audiobook for this. And I want to play you a sample, because when it comes to audiobooks, sometimes the narrator is a hit or miss for some people. I just want you all to hear a little sample, just so you can feel out how the audiobook reads.
Their deviancy to families and employers. Six arrested in perversion case here, read one typical headline. A seaman, 25, of McAllister Street. An auto agency clerk, 27, of Clay Street. A musician, 36, of Taylor Street. A drama coach, 23, of 7th Avenue. A photo refinisher, 43, of Laurel Street. After World War II, homosexual arrests, including those for sodomy, dancing, kissing, or holding hands, occurred at the rate of 1 every 10 minutes, each hour, each day, for 15 years. In sum, 1 million citizens found themselves persecuted by the American state for sexual deviation. Men unable to risk identification had only the public restroom, a space both public and private. When an intruder, a policeman or an unsuspecting passerby, interrupted the ritual.
So, that is a little taste. I really like his voice. I really like how I'm able to listen to his narration and really lose myself in this book. And yeah. Now let's talk about the physical book. The physical book is amazing quality. I got this a year ago. I pre-ordered it when it came out, and it does have a little book plate that is signed by Dr. Eric Cervini. And This is high quality. So this has that little, the dust jacket. Yeah. The dust jacket has this, rose petal-y feel. You see that a lot in, tarot cards, where, like, it's just very soft and, yeah. Texture-wise, it's not my favorite. This one feels a little, it feels a little harsh with my sensory, but, it's high quality, and I'm proud to have this on my bookshelf. So let's get into the actual book and really dig deep into what's in here. Now, I don't want to butcher it, so I'm going to leave a lot of details out because this is a book of details, and it is just amazing. My dyslexic head, I don't think, can't fully condense this and give it to you in a proper review, but it is phenomenal, and I am going to treasure this book. So yeah. Let's talk about this book. The Deviant's War, the Homosexual versus the United States of America, was written by Dr. Eric Cervini. Dr. Eric Cervini is an award-winning historian of LGBTQ+ culture and politics. He graduated summa cum laude from Harvard College and received his PhD in history from University of Cambridge, where he was a Gates Scholar. Now, he is very qualified to write this amazing book about queer history, and this is well researched. So, from page 391 to 494, that is over 100 pages of notes, sources. Notes, sources, index, and research information. So that much is all his cited sources. This book is amazing. This story follows astronomer Frank Kameny. Frank Kameny would have been a household named astronomer, or that would have made history in the great space race if the US government didn't hold him back for being a homosexual. It tells his story in a way that is very, it doesn't read like a history book. It doesn't just throw facts. It makes you engage. It makes you feel like you're not necessarily reliving it, but this feels like a book version of a documentary, like, but with dialogue. Like, it is well put together. In my brain, me being dyslexic, has a really hard time remembering dates, events, and all this, but listening to this on audio really brought it to life for me. I could visualize, I could see what was going on in my head, and it was just phenomenal. Now, there's a lot of things about Frank Kameny that are in this book, and I wish I could tell you everything, but here's what I can tell you. Frank Kameny was not necessarily the founder of the Mattachine Society, but he was the one who brought it to Washington, D.C. and made it one of the first queer groups. Now, the Mattachine Society, the Daughters of The Daughters of Bilitis. I hope I said that name right. In the Gay Liberation Front. They're all, their history is documented in this book, and it takes you on a journey of queer rights, queer liberation, and it's just a very phenomenal book. Now, Frank Kameny, he had a lot of problematic tendencies, I would say, and it doesn't shy away from those tendencies. He's from kind of being his way or the highway, and kind of being exclusionary and whatnot. This briefly talks about the relationship that all the social justice movements at the time that were happening. It talks about the relationship they had and how that they weren't really working together. Which, if they would have worked together, I think it would have been a lot more effective, maybe, possibly. I don't know. History's history, and whatever happened. But you had all these amazing movements going on, and they really didn't connect with each other. Or I would say the gay revolution, like pre-Stonewall gay revolution, I feel was a little bit selfish on his part. I would personally say that, because honestly, I think if Frank Kameny got his security clearance, he wouldn't have fought hard for the whole queer community. I truly believe that. After reading this book, I feel like Frank Kameny wouldn't have put up a big of a revolution or a fight if he got his security clearance to become an astronomer during the Great Space Race. Now, in this time, in this book, you had McCarthyism, you had J. Edgar Hoover's homophobic policies, and in this book, you also have the politics of McCarthyism, where McCarthy just did a communist witch hunt. And then you had J. Edgar Hoover's war against everything. He was at war with the homosexual movement. And it's quite interesting how far and deep this book gets. There is a lot of things in here that I feel that I can't do it justice, like going really in depth. This is a book you have to experience for yourself. This really reads like a story. There is dialogue. There is Eric Cervini basically put the history of gay rights pre-Stonewall into something that reads like a story. And this story is amazing. And it really tells us how we evolved since. But yeah. I wish I could get into the nitty gritty details, but I don't want to butcher the information in this book, because this is a history that everyone in the LGBTQIA+ community should learn about. This is our history book, and I am proud to have it in my collection. So I really hope you enjoyed this mini review of The Deviant's War. I highly recommend you pick it up. I feel like the information in this book is just something we should all know. We should all learn our history. And this book is perfect for that. Now, if you like more videos like this, please consider liking, subscribing, and hitting that little notifications bell down below. And again, leave a comment on what you think of this book, and if you're thinking about reading it. I really enjoy this book, and yeah. Again, please consider liking, subscribing, and hitting that little notifications bell down below for more updates. And thank you so much for coming along this journey with me. This is my way, Nathan's way.